Today we will cover the configuration and calibration of the analog output on the 880 indicator. When you order the analog output, you will receive several pieces of equipment. The part number is 179156. This will contain the analog output card installation instructions, the analog output card itself, a 4-pin connector for the analog card, a cover plate for the back panel, as well as screws to install the card with. Now, on a desktop mount, aka the 880 Universal, you would not need this plate. It can be set aside for future use or if you'd like thrown away. Now, if you have a panel mount 880, you would receive a back plate like this. With this back plate, you would remove the plate that's in here, put in the smaller plate, like so, and then the connector would stick out where you plug in the green 4-pin connector. If you just have the universal mount, again, this is not needed and you will not have the back plate. So first thing we have to do is go into the menu. Now from here, we actually scroll to setup and drop down. In the previous video, we have shown that if you cannot access configuration through the menu, you will need to go through the physical access. Now that we are in the scale, we will scroll to the left to analog out. Here we will drop down. Now at the source, indicates what are we going to be calibrating the output for. If we drop down here, it is set to scale. This means as the weight fluctuates on the scale, so will the analog output. So we will leave that selected. Now is mode. This can vary depending on your situation. However, the most common is often gross. Gross means it will go based off the gross weight, even if there is a tear in the indicator and it is in net mode. The other option is, of course, net. We will stick with gross for this demonstration. Next is the output type. So here we have 0 to 10 volts. For this demonstration, we will be scrolling right twice for 4 to 20 milliamps. Now as we hit enter, it is accepted. The error action indicates what should the scale do if there is an error condition. Full scale is the first selected option. There is also hold the current millivolt output or go to a zero scale millivolt output. For this particular demonstration, the zero scale output would be 4 millivolts, the full scale output would be 20 millivolts. We will go back and accept a full scale error. The minimum indicates the minimum amount of weight that will be measured by the analog output. We will be using zero as zero is what we want to go to a minimum. Minimum negative. It will be used if the minimum value is a negative number. For example, if we are going from negative 500 to 1,000 pounds, we would turn min neg on and then set the minimum to 500. For this demonstration, we will leave this off. Maximum. This is the max amount of weight that will be tracked by the analog output. We will actually be going to 5,000 for this demonstration. Here you have the ability to change where the decimal point location is. We could go anywhere from 5 up to 50,000. We will accept 5,000 for this demonstration. Max negative, same as the minimum negative. If your maximum is going to be a negative number, you would set this to on. However, for this demonstration, we will be leaving it off. Tweak zero. When we push enter here, as you can see, the value changed on the voltmeter. This automatically changes and does not reflect what is currently on the scale. In order to calibrate, we actually need to set this number to whatever we're seeing on our voltmeter. We will scroll this up to 3.98 and hit enter. And again, we select the decimal point location, enter. It will now cal, and as you can see, it went to 4 millivolts. We are now at tweak span. If we drop down, we can see 19.98. Again, this is the same as before. We type in the number. Once we have 19.98 on there, we hit enter the first time, and now we select our decimal point location. We move it to 19.98 and hit enter. It calibrates, and the milliamp changed to 20. Now that we've exited configuration, we can see that zero is equating to the 4 milliamps as it should. And as we turn it up, and we reach 5,000, it has reached 20. Now, even if we go over, since we stopped at 5,000 for our max value, it will not change. This has been a demonstration of calibrating and configuring the 880 analog output.